Welcome to Atlanta Live. I'm your host, Evangelist Jordan Coletta with JBB Ministries and the Jordan B Band. We are so blessed to have you join us tonight. We have an incredible, incredible program tonight. We have some guests who are just on fire for the Lord, serving the Lord, building up the body of Christ. And you're going to hear a lot of that tonight. We have great music. It's just going to be a wonderful evening. And tonight we pray that through the program, through our time together, that the Lord first, that He anoints you, that He blesses you, that He encourages you, and that He assures you of His amazing love for you. You know, we are fashioned, we are made in the likeness and the image of Jesus Christ, of our Lord. We are built to His design, and he will never forsake us. He wants us to have a fabulous, fabulous faith walk. And with that, we're going to jump right in to some great music. We're going to hear from Mignon, and she's going to sing, "I Win." Take it away.
Father God, I never thought that I would make it this far. But with a faith the size of a mustard seed, I knew I would win. Didn't think I could take it. Life came rushing down, my head spinning around.
Yeah, yeah.
Suffocating, about to drown. My heart felt like it hit the ground.
Yeah, yeah.
Shattered into a million pieces. The thought of it had me speechless. But if it had not been for you, Lord, where would I be? Where would I be? Someone like me, would go through much for my destiny. Nobody knew what I went through. I kept it to myself, no one but you. I never had a love like this. You I found. All the joy within my soul no longer bound. Your love for me, nobody else could ever give.
Mignon, that was absolutely, absolutely incredible. Wow. And more coming. And with that, we get to jump right into, I think, who's just an amazing an amazing guest. Her name is Stephanie Ford. She is on fire for the Lord. The Lord has her working day and night, doing His will, His works, each and every day. And with that, thank you for being here tonight.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate that.
Oh, we love having you. You know, I know you are just on fire for Jesus Christ. I want to start right there. What motivates you every morning to get rolling and doing the things you do with your ministry?
Just knowing that He gave me another chance.
Mm.
He gave me another chance. He gave me a chance to love Him wholeheartedly, to do His work and His will and not mine. Mm. It's been a great journey. My journey started back in 2015. I gave my life back to Christ.
Mm.
I told the Lord, I said, Lord, tell me where you want me to go. Tell me what you want me to do, and I'll do it. I told the Lord, I said, I'll run for you the rest of my life.
Mm.
And with me making that statement to God, He's holding me to it.
And I get the sense you're holding you to it as well.
Absolutely.
I mean, there's no question. Now, prior to that, you used to have a very good relationship and faith base, and then fell away.
Yeah, fell
away.
Can
you talk a little bit about that?
Yes. Fell away. I got divorced.
Sorry to hear that.
How many of you know that brokenness take you to places that you don't think you'll go and keep you longer than you think you'll be?
Mm.
I was a broken woman. I left my husband back in 2004, and I was a broken woman, spirit, mind, and everything. I walked away from the Lord for about 10 years.
Wow.
10 years. Back in 2015, my niece called me, and she said, Auntie, she said, I'm getting ready to get baptized. She said, I want to know if you'll come. And in that moment, I was still on the phone, because I had a choice to make.
Mm.
I was going to go right or I was going to go left. And I went right. And when I tell you, God met me at that church that day, it was absolutely amazing. It changed my life.
Wow.
And in that moment, I told God, I said, Lord, tell me what you want me to do. Show me where you want me to go, and I'll do it. And 2016, I birthed my ministry.
That's
amazing. I birthed my ministry. Because what people don't really understand is that God can use those broken pieces.
Yes, yes.
He can use those broken pieces. It doesn't matter where you've been. It doesn't matter what you've done. God can still use you.
Mm.
But you got to get into His will. And once you get into His will, it will be done.
Amen.
And so 2016, I started my nonprofit organization called Area in Need Missionary House.
Mm.
I started off very humbly. We started off with nothing.
Like in your house?
Like in my house, in my house, in my garage.
Wow.
And we did our ministry out of my house for 4 years.
Wow.
4 years. And what we do, Area in Need service to homeless men, women, and children that live in hotels and extended stays.
Mm.
And so what that means is that we actually take the event out to the hotels, and we set up in the hotel parking lots. We give out clothes, shoes, food, toiletries.
Wow.
We have a kids' corner. We do free HIV testing, free diabetes screenings. We have a second chance housing program, and all of that. We have 4 hotels that we service. We have 2 in Clayton County, 1 in DeKalb County, and 1 out on Fulton Industrial. And guess what? We just expanded to LaGrange, Georgia.
Wow.
Because there's such a need in LaGrange.
Mm.
We service the Motel 6 in LaGrange, and we also service Amberwood Senior Living Facility in LaGrange.
Wow.
And when I tell you, my team in LaGrange is absolutely awesome.
I bet.
Yes, yes. And I can say this, I don't do this alone. I have a strong board. I have to really shout out my vice president. Her name is Tara Neal. Actually, my whole team, Tara Neal, she's my vice president. I have a secretary. Her name is Chandra Gates-Fields. Mr. Aaron Alexander, he's one of our board members. Mm. Mr. Byron Freeman, Ms. Marcia Freeman. My LaGrange team, I have Maxine Farrell Bailey. She's my vice president. Tara Truitt, she is my president. Ms. Shonda Brown, she's my secretary. And my treasurer, Ms. Samantha Thompson in LaGrange. Wow. So I have a team of people that makes this happen for Area in Need Missionary House.
Wow. Yeah. I mean, to go from literally the Lord whispering what he wanted you to do
yes.
to where you are today. And I suspect, even though you've had amazing growth for the Lord,
yes.
but I some tells me that this is just the start, albeit fabulous foundation. Now, you have an event coming up this weekend, too, don't you?
Yes, we do. We have an event coming up this Saturday in Noonan, Georgia. You know, the people in Noonan were devastated by the tornado. And I wanted to do something. I wanted to do something because we are our brother's keeper.
Yes.
And so what I did was I talked to, we have partnered with a lot of Masonic lodges, sororities, churches, and different things like that. We were at an event doing a food drive, and some of the Masonic brothers told another Masonic brother in Noonan, and he's a physician. His name is Dr. Maurice Gilbert. And he contacted me because he said that he wanted to partner with me, that he wanted to also do something in Noonan.
Wow.
And so we collaborated, and we have a team of our partners, and it's called Area in Need Missionary House and Partners, a disaster relief project that we're doing on this Saturday from 11 to 2. And we are going to service the men, women, and children, everybody that was affected in Noonan. We are going to have the 1,300 USDA food boxes that are donated to us. We're going to have clothes, shoes, toiletries, non-perishables, household items. You know, we just want to love on Noonan. We want to show them our love. And what better way is to serve those that are in need.
Absolutely.
You know, that's what we do. That's what we are here for. You know, it's not about us. It's about serving. And that's what we do.
Yeah.
That's what we do.
You are the Spirit of God. I am just getting blown away by the Spirit of God right now. I think it's amazing, too, that all of this has been accomplished. I mean, pretty much, you know, you're not sponsored. You are pretty much, you've been doing this by people just providing as you have gone along. And you turn that right around and, you know, buy things, get things donated, whatever.
Yes.
And the type of services that you provide in these critical areas, because I think a lot of people don't really understand that it's tough to find housing.
Yes.
And people will gravitate, if they can get up enough money, they'll go ahead and go to these hotels and the extended stay hotels and such, and it provides them shelter. But they really, in many instances, lack some critical things. And these are individuals and their families and all.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So you come in with all these services and things that you provide. In some instances, you'll be providing things that they would probably never get their hands on.
Exactly.
Is that true?
That is absolutely the truth.
Mm.
Well, I have a great statement to make right now.
Okay.
2020, last year, we opened up Area in Need Community Development Center. And that's located at 681 Highway 138 in Riverdale, Georgia.
Wow.
And what we do at the center, everything that we could not provide our clients outside in the element,
right.
God gave me a vision to open up a center. And at this center, we have a Southside Works program. This is where we actually help people, you know, do their resumes, find jobs. We have a financial literacy program where we actually help people with, you know, their credit. You know, you have a lot of people that don't know their credit score. You have a lot of people that don't know how to budget. So we have a financial literacy program in place that actually we have partnered with Regions Bank with.
Wow.
They are going to be doing our financial literacy class. And also with our Southside Works program, we have partnered with the Ringer Center. The Ringer Center actually is going to be donating their services to our organization. We actually just won a service from them. They did a fundraiser, and four organizations were put in this hat, and people had to vote and donate. and the person that with the most votes won. And guess who won? Area in Need Missionary House won. And so that is critical. And then also at the center, we have a food pantry. We have a clothing closet. We have a second chance housing program, and we have case assessment. So in order for people to be able to access our services, they have to join our program.
Okay.
And so it's the Because We Care program, how appropriate.
Yes, yes, yes.
And so they actually join our Because We Care program. And once they join that program, our program, we actually help to try to bridge the gap between homelessness and permanent housing. Mm-hmm. And we have more like a wraparound service. We have a wraparound service. So we are touching the masses. We are touching the masses. We're also going to be doing an event with Clayton County Solicitor's Office, Solicitor Brooks and Victor Hill on the 24th of March as well. So we're going to be giving out about 1,300 food boxes at that event as well. So we are all around the city. LaGrange.
You're loving LaGrange.
You know, because that's my hometown. That's where I was born and raised, and we just started servicing LaGrange last year. Like I told you before, we have the Motel 6, we have the Amberwood, we have Amberwood Assistant Living, and we have one of the young, my president, she actually works with the Troup County School System, and so we provide the food boxes to them as well during our events. So we've partnered with Kathy in LaGrange, that's Community Action for Improvement. We've partnered with them in LaGrange. We have Pastor Michael Jackson with Confidence Missionary Baptist Church. We partner with him. He does a lot of things with our organization as well. So we have a lot of partnerships that are crucial to what we do. And especially here in the Metro Atlanta area, we have a lot of partners here. We have a lot of donors, and I'm so, so grateful for them. I'm so grateful for them because without our donors, without the things that they give us, because we wouldn't be able to make it. We wouldn't be able to make it.
Well, and what I think is amazing is like this, all this donor activity really is kind of new. It pretty much everything else has been through the years, literally just people throwing a couple dollars here and there in the basket or in the jar.
They go to our website, you know, they hear about what we're doing in the community.
Yeah.
I'll get a phone call, somebody will call me and say, Stephanie, we want to help. And I said, go on our website, make a donation. You know, we need your help, we need your support. And so now that we've partnered with a lot of the Masonic organizations, the you know, they've actually came in and partnered with us, and they actually help service at each one of these hotels. I don't want to start naming names because if I forget somebody.
I know, I understand. But I mean, I think your point is you have a true appreciation of all these individuals and companies and organizations that have kind of encompass what you're doing. And I think most importantly, because what you're doing, I think we are recognizing now as a society the criticality of these new kind of shelters. I mean, the old days, it was like, because I have a ministry that goes to prisons and homeless shelters. So, you know, you're speaking my language. But I think the key here is, you know, you are doing things in kind of these hidden shelters.
Yes. Yes.
And I think a lot of organizations and all are realizing we need to provide some support here. And I think I think that's so nice to see this, because at the end of the day, like you said, we need to help serve those in need. Now, before we run out of time, I want to make sure we could have people tonight saying, I would love, first of all, to you know, you went through a lot of the things that are going on, and there's a lot going on all year round. So how do people get in touch with you to understand what's going on with the ministry and get some of those dates that you talked about?
Okay. They can actually visit our website, which is areainneed.org. They can go on our website. They can view what we do all year long. We have, you can go to our donation page tab there. You can make a donation. We are in need of donations. We would love for you guys to sow into our ministry because it's needed. It's needed even for what we're doing on Saturday. You know, we still need supplies. We still need things. It's not too late. You know, so, you know, we need help. Our telephone number at Area Need Community Development Center is 770-907-0025. And they can also reach me at 404-295-7916. And that's my cell number. And everybody say, you give your cell number out? I'm like, yes, I'm available.
I want a phone call.
I want a phone call. Because, you know, it's selfless. You know, what we do is selfless. And if I get a phone call, that means that somebody want to reach me and they actually want to help Area in Need Missionary House. And I'm available for whoever calls.
In a second.
In a second.
Well, I suspect that tonight, you know, you we're going to have people tonight who say, I would like to donate. I'd like to know more. I'd like to pray for you. I may want to come out and help lend a hand. And I guess any of that's okay, right?
Yes, all of that. We welcome our volunteers because that's how we make this thing work. Because it's your volunteers, the people that have the same heart.
Yes.
That you want.
Yes.
You want those people that want to give back.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? You don't want somebody grumpy, umpy coming out. You want somebody with the same heart.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That want to serve somebody else because it's not about you.
That's right.
That's what I have to keep you telling. It's not about us. It's not about us.
That's right.
It's God's will and God's work.
Well, I just want you to know you are such a blessing what you're doing. And I know you don't do it for the accolades, but I'm just going to tell you, I receive just your spirit and all the things you're trying to get accomplished and getting accomplished. And I really appreciate you coming out tonight and describing this to us.
Well, thank you so much for having me on your platform. And I pray that we'll be able to come back soon to let you know about some upcoming events.
Absolutely. Love to have you back.
Okay. Thank you.
Wow. I tell you, you know, when you hear about how individuals like Stephanie and her organization and all those people around her are serving those in need, it's so humbling. And I tell you, it's motivating. It's motivating because you see the love of and for one another, and what a blessing that is. Amen and amen. Well, we now get a chance to listen again to that angel, beautiful voice, great music. Mignon will be singing Alabaster Box. And with that, you're up.
Them with my hair.
Mignon. Oh, the voice of an angel. Oh my goodness, what a blessing having you tonight.
Thank you. I'm excited about being here.
Hey, thanks for being here.
Thank you.
Well, I love, we were talking earlier,
yes.
And I love when we're talking, you started singing at the age of 2.
Yes, at the age of 2.
That's amazing.
Yes.
And you come from a musical family.
Absolutely.
So it was
everyone
not,
sings.
That's what I'm saying, everyone sings, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Now, for you and your ministry and what you're doing with music, you have a couple new singles out, right?
Yes.
Can you talk a little bit about that?
So, I Win was the first single that was released last year. I'm so excited about it. It was ministry, you know, and the song really talked about the place that I was, where God brought me from, going through the ups and downs of life, and to remember and always know that God is in the middle of every situation that we go through, and ultimately, we do win. So that was my first testimony that was birthed, and I thank God for that. And then In His Presence was the second single that was released last year. And look, God is so good because God allowed me to release songs even in a pandemic. Mm. But when God has purposed you to do something, and He said, I know the plan that I have for you, a plan to prosper you, not to cause evil or harm, but to give you a hope in the future, that means God has already made provision for it. Okay. So In His Presence was birthed, and I'm here today, and I'm so excited about what God is doing in and through my life.
That's
Amen.
Awesome. And
yes.
And you also are blessed to be able to co-write
yes.
with your husband.
Yes. Yes, we co-wrote I Win, and then, of course, he wrote In His Presence, so yes.
That is awesome.
Yes.
Now, we have just a little bit of time. I want to make sure if someone listening or many people listening tonight say, I love your music, I'd love to know more about, you know, what you're doing with your ministry, I'd love to have you come out to our church and
yes.
sing, do a concert or whatever. How do they get in touch with you?
So first you can visit my website at www.mignonharris.com. That you can go there too to download all of my singles, as well as Facebook, it's Willetta Mignon Harris, and Instagram at Mignon Harris as well.
Awesome.
Yes.
Okay. And then also you're an author.
Yes, I am.
Just a brief minute, can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yes, God allowed me to write this book last year as well. A lot happened last year. But a birthing, it's entitled Finding Your Voice Through Divorce, and it was birthed out of my first marriage. And so the gist of the Bible, the word says to obey the voice of God. When God is speaking to us, oftentimes we omit when he is talking, and we listen and we open ourselves up to receive from other things and outside forces. And God just place in my spirit, hear my voice only. And when I follow the voice of God, and there you have it.
Everything
yeah.
unfolds.
Everything happens
yeah.
through obedience, through his
obedience.
Word. Yes, absolutely.
Wow. I receive that. And I love the fact that you take these gifts. You have such a beautiful voice,
Thank
a beautiful
you.
Message. Just you're on fire for the Lord.
Yes, I love God.
I receive it.
Yes.
So, the other thing I want to mention just before we have you sing again. So if someone tonight wanted you to go out and actually sing at their
yes.
church, at their event or whatever,
yes.
that's no problem, right?
That's
You'll
no
do
problem.
That.
Yes.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Probably ought to.
No problem whatsoever.
Yeah.
Yes.
Good, good, good. So you're going to sing another song?
Absolutely.
And what
yes.
are you going to sing?
You Say.
You Say?
Yes.
Awesome. Well,
yes.
I'm looking forward to that. Thank
you
for being here.
Thank
blessings
you so much.
You.
I love your spirit. Awesome.
Amen.
Thank you.
Every high and every low.
Amen, amen, and amen. Mignon, that was absolutely outstanding. An angel amongst us. And we'll have her close out the program with a song here. But now we get another opportunity to turn and listen to and speak with a person who's on fire for the Lord. She's doing so much. She is a TV evangelist. She's a talk show host. Actually, one of which is here at Atlanta Live. She's a prophet and an author. She runs and has founded several ministries. She has so much going on. And with that, we get to speak with Dr. Deborah Isom.
Hello. How are you tonight?
By the grace of God, I am doing so well. Thank you so
much
for being here.
You are amazing, too. And I just want to thank you for having me on. And I thank Joanna as well. And say that you do an excellent job with what you do here, hosting, and your music, your band, your preaching, your real estate. You just got so much going on. You're talking about, I have a lot going on. I don't know how you're standing.
Hey, that's only by the grace of God. Thank you for all that. You know, I love all the things you have going on right now. I mean, I think all of them are so rich for the Lord Jesus Christ, and you're on fire for the Lord.
God is good. I'm telling you, your guests, all of your guests were talking about the same thing that I want to talk about, and it's just following God.
Yes.
You know, all of them talked about the fact that when you hear His voice and you do what He asks you to do, He'll just lay out the red carpet for you. He'll just say, okay, you know, here's all, everything you need. Here's the money. Here's the resources. Here are the people. And that's just what God does. Mm. And I just love the fact that when people ask me, well, how do I get started? I feel like I have a call of God on my life. And how do I get started? The first thing I say is just what both of your guests said, listen to God. Mm. Let Him give you the instructions. Because before the foundations of the earth, He birthed in us what it is that we're supposed to do on this earth. You know, it's so unfortunate that people sometimes get the abilities that they have and the gifts that they have with the call and and the purpose of what God has for them to do. You know, God's going to use all of your gifts and all of your abilities, but He wants to use them for the purpose.
Yes.
Because there's a one purpose that we have in this earth. And when we hear Him and we get on fire to get that purpose accomplished, God just does amazing things, and that excites me.
I can tell, and that's awesome. But you bring out a great point, because I think a lot of us aren't sure if we're worthy of doing anything for the Lord. Are we being called to do some, or will one day we get called? But your point is, we all have the Lord has something in mind for every one of us.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And I love the fact that you hit on something that so many people, because we have a school of ministry. So we have a school where we actually train people to be what God has already called them to be. Mm-hmm. But so often people call me up about the school and they say, well, but I've done this and I messed up over here. And, you know, am I worthy to do this thing that God has called me to do? And I think to myself, God called you before the foundations of the earth, so He knew every place that you were going to mess up at. He knew every divorce. He knows every abortion. He knows every time you're going to curse somebody out, you're going to do all these things. Does God want us to do all those things? No. But He knows that we're fallible. He knows that we make mistakes. He knows that we get divorces. We have abortions. We do all those things. But guess what? When we become born again, we are forgiven. Past, present, and future. Mm. And God, if God could use Moses, who was a murderer,
yep.
If so many people say, well, I had an abortion, that's murder. We don't have to figure out if Moses was a murderer. He was a murderer.
Look at Saul.
Saul, you see what I'm saying? So we sometimes are our own worst enemies.
Yeah, our own critics.
That's right. Yeah. God has already set us up to prosper and to be in good health and to be amazing and to do all of these wonderful things. And we talk ourselves out of it because we listen to the enemy.
That's what I was thinking.
Speaking in our ear.
Yeah.
He's trying to say, oh, you had an abortion. Oh, you did this wrong. You did that wrong. You were in jail. You're homeless. All these things. But guess what? If we turn all of that over to God, God makes a perfect little piece for us to stand on that testimony. Mm. That testimony is not to destroy you, it's to be a stepping stone so that you can go forward and do all of the great things that God has called us to. And the thing that it reminds me of is Joyce Meyer. Joyce Meyer talks about having been divorced. She talks about the fact that she stole money from her job. She talks about all of these things. Her father raped her as a child. Mm. She talks about all of these horrible things, but those things don't destroy her. They give her a platform to stand on.
That's right.
And that's what we have to begin to understand. So when people call me up and say, I feel like God has called me to do something great, but I'm ashamed because I did, stand on top of it.
Mm.
Make that your platform. Let people know God can use the devastating things to build us a platform and let us stand tall for Him. That's my message.
Amen. And I think with that is you end up having so much relevancy around in having all this knowledge, not that you want to repeat it, but the fact is you have these experiences as you've described.
Exactly.
And so when you're in a ministry capacity and someone is going through something, it's not just academics to you. You've lived it. People have lived these things, and you can lend that appropriate guidance.
I think you have hit it right on the head. And that's why you're a great evangelist, because you can go out and tell people just what I just said. Mm. Stand on top of it. Let it be a stepping stone for you. So I love that. I love the fact that you're saying, we don't want to go out and do it again. We don't want to go have more abortions or more divorces or more, you know, stealing or whatever you've done wrong.
Sure.
But you know what? It makes people say, you are somebody I can relate to.
Yeah.
It reminds me of something Eddie Long said. He said a long time ago, he said, if you're perfect and you've never done anything wrong, that's great. He said, but you can't preach to me.
Right.
He said, the only somebody can preach to me who has failed.
That's right.
And God brought them back around, set them up, and they have a testimony to say that God can deliver and God can heal and God can bless.
That's right. Amen.
Amen.
And I think earlier you mentioned this, and I think this is key for all of us, is that the devil will use anything he can to try to deflate us, to divert us, to get us away from the Lord. And as soon as he starts doing that, we try to deal with all that nonsense and stuff that, you know, he's a fallen angel. He's got no authority, but boy, he can be the biggest nag.
Yes, he can.
But he'll try to keep us away from doing the Lord's work, because he already knows, like you said, as you start going down the road of doing the Lord's will, he thinks that's the worst part. The devil thinks that's the worst. Here's another one going to do the Lord's work.
That's exactly right. So that's why I tell people, you know, if you feel called, if you feel like God is calling you to do anything, you know, especially fivefold ministry, apostle, prophet, teacher, evangelist, pastor, you have got to get yourself in a position where you can fulfill the call of God. Because let me tell you something, nothing is greater than to know you're in the will of God. Mm. And when you're in the will of God, you experience an open heaven. You know, your first guest talked about the fact that God started, she said yes to God when he called her to do her ministry. And then she started finding people that wanted to help her, and people wanted to sow into her, and people wanted to show up and meet her in these places. That's what happens.
That's right.
When you're in the will of God, when you're in the perfect will of God, you will find that every single thing that you need will show up at your doorstep. I was telling the young lady, we needed a truck for our homeless ministry because we get clothes and things that need to be donated and shuffled around. Yeah. And I was telling my husband, I said, we need to get a truck. And we don't like to be in debt, so we like things to be paid for. And so my husband said, okay, well, maybe we can just go into debt and maybe get this. We got a check in the mail. We didn't tell people. We didn't broadcast it out that we needed. We got a check in the mail. We were able to take that check, write a check out, and get that truck, because that's what God does. Mm. If you're doing the will of God, God will bless you. And the reason that I'm talking about this is so many people, they know they're called to ministry, but they don't want to do it because they think it's going to be so hard and it's going to be. But if you're in the will of God, it's not hard.
Yeah.
Because what God orders, he always pays for.
Absolutely.
He pays for every single thing that he orders. Glory be to God.
Well, right, so, amen. No, that's great. I also think that we should spend a few minutes, because I think this would be a perfect time, because I can imagine our audience getting excited, saying, boy, you know, you've talked about ministries. There's people who you do ministry training, preparing people to be ministers. I could see people saying, I'd love to know more about that. Should I do that? How do they get in touch with you, and what resources can they, you know, start looking at tonight if someone wanted to do that?
Okay, if someone wants to get in contact with me, they can certainly go to BAM, Begin Again, our ministry is Begin Again Ministry, so it's BAMATL.org. Or if they're interested in school, we have a school for ordination if you want to be trained and ordained into your area of ministry, apostle, prophet, teacher, evangelist, or pastor. Or if you want a degree, starting from associates all the way up to a doctoral degree, then they can go to Aaron's Beard, ISOM, International School of Ministry.com, and contact us that way. Or you can always call us at our office, 770-306-1453. We want to hear from you.
Yeah, it's like a one-stop shop to be able to fully understand what's available and then to start doing it.
Exactly. Yeah. It's absolutely true. I want to tell them about my book.
That's next thing on my mind.
On your list, right?
Yes, ma'am. Please do so. Jump right in.
Yes. I mean, I did a part one of this, a volume one of this, So You Say You Are a Prophet, A Simple Guide to the Prophetic, several years ago. But people kept saying, well, you know, we need a little bit more on that particular topic. So I kind of expanded the same thing, the same topic, but a little bit more meat in that particular area. Because a lot of times people will say to me, well, I prophesy, so does that make me a prophet? Mm-hmm. Well, anybody who has the Holy Spirit on the inside of them can prophesy. Because prophecy is really only hearing the voice of God, which if you're born again, you hear the voice of God, mm-hmm. and saying what you've heard God say. Right. So anybody can do that. So that doesn't necessarily make you a prophet. You know what I mean? When you are operating as a prophet, then a basic prophecy is edification, exhortation, and comfort. Edify, build up, exhort, bring a person back on track with God, or bring them close to God. and comfort, make you feel good.
Yeah.
So anybody can do that. And a prophet does that, but they do some other things too. You know, they confirm prophecy. They give direction and bring correction. They also will warn if something is coming along. And through the prophet, other things can manifest, like healing, all kinds of things like that. So we talk about that in the book. There could be prophetic counseling can take place. But let me tell you something. If you are a fivefold ministry gift, an apostle, a prophet, a teacher, an evangelist, a pastor, you should be prophesying. You should be hearing God's voice. You should be telling people what God is saying, because we're in a season. We are in a season where things are kind of a little crazy.
Yep.
And people need to know what God has to say about
That's
where
right.
we are. And let me tell you something. If you get in the will of God, if you get in the face of God, hallelujah, He's going to let you know that all things are working together for good for those who love the Lord and who are called according to His purpose. Let me tell you something. The world might be going crazy, but God's people, we are sailing right down the middle of the lane because God is in control. So, guys, I want you to go on Amazon.com and find this book. It's going to be a blessing to you.
Awesome. So, speaking of prophet and prophetic messages, what has the Lord shared with you about kind of the times that we're in, and how to, you know, understand this a little bit better?
Yeah. Well, you know what? When all of this pandemic started to happen, the Lord began to say that this is a season. Now, God didn't bring the pandemic.
Right.
The pandemic came from Satan. We know that. But God says in this season, because He can work out good in any situation, He said He was drawing His people unto Himself, because He's given us new direction as to what it is that when we fully come out of this pandemic, we're going to have new marching orders. For instance, there are books that are in you that God is saying He's going to begin to pull out of you. Mm. He said, you do a lot of things already, but God says there are so many other things that you should be doing to reach His people. He
Amen.
Said there's an author on the inside of you. So for you, that's one thing that God is going to start pulling out of you, praise God. But God said
Amen.
There's so many other things that people just, they haven't, I hear the Lord saying also other businesses are going to come. He said the real estate is a good business. He said, but there are other businesses that are coming your way.
Wow.
He said, and He's bringing partners to come around you to begin to speak into you and to begin to stir that entrepreneur spirit even the more. He said, so look out for those people. And He said, there are even going to be some people that He's going to start pushing away from you because they are stagnating the anointing of business on the inside of you. So the Lord said, it's a season where there's going to be a lot of increase, a lot of prosperity is coming your way. He said, there are going to be some people who are not going to understand how all of this is going to begin to flow out of you. And He said, those are the people you're going to know that you're going to have to start letting some of those people go. He said, but this is a new season for you to begin to build in greater ways.
Amen. Wow.
And the real estate is going to do well. He said, even explode. He said, so just stay in that vein as well. But
wow.
So God says that when He pulled us in during this season of pandemic, He said it was because He wanted to show us some other areas on the inside of us. Because when we come out, He said the body of Christ, the church, is going to come out stronger than ever before. He said, so we need to just be aware of that and listen to Him, begin to write things down, because we're coming out with a greater glory.
So we really, I mean, that's a great way to think of this. So the bottom line is this is almost like a prep time.
There you go.
Of what's going to eventually, for all of us,
that's exactly right,
going to come to fruition.
That's
what
exactly
the Lord has in store for this next chapter.
That's right. So He said, we just got to get ready, because
wow.
it's going to be explosive. It's going to be amazing. He said, we're sitting under an open heaven.
I love it. I think the other thing that puts a perspective on is the idea that, you know, a lot of us get down about all this stuff, all the craziness, the losses in many areas. But really what, you know, when you think about it, all that is bad. Don't get me wrong. But I think what you're describing tonight is we have to kind of say, put that in perspective, say, yes, these things have happened. It's not the Lord doing it, but it has happened.
Yes, yes.
But coming out of it is going to be some real positive things for everybody.
Right.
And just be ready for that, and don't get tugged down by living back all this stuff that we have now experienced. Understand that's bigger things are coming and be ready for them. And pray for them, right?
That's right.
Pray
for them, right? Prayer is so very important. Mm. You're absolutely right. And you're preaching a good message right there, evangelist, because so many people, you're right, they've gotten depressed and they've fallen down. But God says this is a season when we come out of this, a greater glory for the kingdom of God. And because you're an evangelist, I got to say this. God says this is a season that he's preparing a great burst of the evangelistic spirit.
Awesome.
He says so many people, they're ripe and they're ready to be brought into the kingdom of God. He says, so he's preparing us to have a word to say and to speak into the heart of the broken so that they can know that God has a good plan for their lives and he wants to do something amazing for them.
I received that, and I had such a great, strong message for all this tonight. I just want to tell you how much we appreciate you being here tonight.
Praise God. I always love being with you. You're an amazing man of God.
You are so kind. Thank you so much. Wow. Well, the time is just slipping away. We get another opportunity in a minute here to listen to some beautiful music, but I hope that tonight that the Lord has encouraged you. I mean, as you've heard tonight, I mean, the Lord Jesus Christ is working in so many different avenues. But most importantly, he is working to make sure that each of us have a faith walk that's incredible. That he loves us more than anything. That tonight, I believe through what we've heard, he's encouraging each of us to really understand and to dwell and to pray on what's coming. The love of God unfolding even more so than he ever has at the height of our faith. So tonight we pray for each of our faiths, and we pray that the Lord has blessed you and will continue to bless you. And with that, we get to close out the show with Mignon, and she'll be singing In His Presence. With that, take it away, Mignon.
Just